Let's get the latest on the quake damage in Sarangani and other areas in southern Philippines. We have Jory May Balmediano, Information Officer 2 of the Office of Civil Defense in Region 12. Good afternoon, Jory May, and welcome to Top Story.
Yes, po. Good afternoon po for all those na nakikinig po for this afternoon.
All right. Maraming salamat for joining us today. We've been reporting 7 dead so far. What is the latest in terms of death toll? And perhaps if you could also give us the number of injured from the earthquake.
This day, the reported, with regards to the reported death for Sani province, we have recorded or reported that coming from different local DRRM officers in the General Santa City, Grand Malapatan, a total of 6 deaths due to the earthquake that happened yesterday. And with that, we also have reports of a total of 433 persons who experienced hyperventilation because of anxiety and panic attack in different parts of General Santos City, Banga, Tiboli, Tampakan, Tupi, Corona del City of South Cotabato, Alabel, Clan, Kiamba, Malapatan, Malungon, of Sarangani Province, and of Makilala. Of Cotabato Province.
Okay, so just to clarify that report, you are so far recording 6 dead instead of 7. Am I correct?
Yes, as of this time, for Region 12 alone, we have confirmed that death of only 6 persons.
Okay, so that's for Region 12. Now, what about missing persons? Are there reports of persons that have not been found since yesterday?
With regards to our missing persons, we have reported a total of 2 missing persons that are coming from the municipality of Glan.
Okay, so that's 2 missing persons, 6 dead, and 133 persons suffering from hyperventilation and panic as a result of the earthquake.
For correction, it's a total of 433.
Okay, that's 433. Now, Jory May, running total cost of damage, which one is the hardest hit in terms of municipalities? Do you have that figure?
Yes. Could you repeat that for a moment, folks?
Yes. Do you have the figure for the cost of damage, even just a running total, perhaps, and which town is considered hardest hit?
With regards for the cost of damage, the assessment team, our rapid damage assessment team, is still on the ground right now and doing the costing with regards to damage. The LGU of Glan, the LGU of Malapatan, and as well as the LGU of Alabel, and they are already on the field doing the rapid damage assessment and its analysis, and as well our Department of Education and Schools team. That's why we cannot forward or we cannot report or present any costing of damage of this time.
Okay, no damage cost just of yet. What about the condition of those in temporary shelters? Have you evacuated some residents to temporary shelters from yesterday?
From the incident, the LGU of Glan have conducted a preemptive evacuation for a barangay of Pangyan because of fear of a possible tsunami incident. And a total of 900 individuals, more or less 180 families were evacuated to the safest area and in their barangay. But as of today, all those IDPs that were reported have already returned to their homes.
Okay, so they have returned. No evacuees there so far. What about the structural integrity, Jory May, structural integrity of buildings? A cause of concern whenever there's an earthquake. Are there ongoing inspections now of major infrastructure or buildings that might have been affected by the quake, considering that there could be aftershocks still?
Yes, as of now, there are buildings that are closed right now. Like, for example, we have the malls are undergoing assessment of regards to its integrity, like the SM General Santos City, where there's a damaged portion of their ceiling, and the Robinson's Mall, there is the atrium where area are collapsed or has a collapsed ceiling, and there are also some minor damages in some hospitals that were already reported to us, like the South Cotabato Provincial Hospital with some minor cracks, and the Soco Medics building with some minor damages. And the engineering offices of the respective LGU are ongoing conduct of their assessment to ensure the integrity of those following buildings. And the SM, the Robinson Mall, and the KCC Mall here in General Santos City, there are portions there na they're not yet allowing any customers as of this moment.
All right, Jeremy Baldemiano of OCD 12, thank you so much for the information that you've shared with us. Stay safe.
Thank you so much.